Warm welcome. Very good afternoon from Dhaka, Bangladesh. This is Munira Sultana. Poppy have joined from our country, Bangladesh. And here we have renowned personality from Kenya. Warm welcome, Mr. Jonathan Metit. How are you today?
I'm fine, thank you. Thank you, Munira, for taking me in for this meeting.
Okay, so here our thanks a lot for joining. And Mr. Jonathan, our honorable viewers, please help me to let you understand. He is accounts assistant, disability mainstreaming champion, and member disability mainstreaming committee from Technical University Mombasa. Warm welcome. Very happy to be connected with you at this international platform. Mr. Jonathan Metit, I will request you, please share your introduction kindly. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Munira. As you have said, my name is Jonathan Metit from Technical University of Mombasa. I work as an accounts assistant. I'm also disability mainstreaming champion. And disability mainstreaming committee member. Yes, I have worked in the institution for the last 23 years as in the, that is public service, and I'm also a parent of a child with disability. This is what has inspired me to advocate for persons with disability across the country. Okay, my home county is Kericho. That is where I was born and schooled at Sosit Primary School. Then I went to Kericho High School, which is also in Kericho. Then from there, I started working in 1998 in Mombasa, then the Mombasa Polytechnic, now Technical University of Mombasa.
Okay, great, your work experience. What is your vision, Mr. Jonathan? Can you please share?
Yeah, my vision is actually to advocate for persons with disabilities in Kenya and across the world so that they can be incorporated in all spheres of life, education, welfare, and everything, every equal opportunity that they are supposed to be given. In, as per our laws in Kenya, we are supposed to include persons with disability in leadership and education. And education is a key empowerment for persons with disability. Here at Technical University of Mombasa, the University Council and Vice Chancellor Professor Laila Abubakar and University Management fully supports fulfilling the constitutional provision and implementing the affirmative action plan for including people with disability in all areas, staff, and clients and students.
Okay, that's great. So what you want to achieve through your service, Mr. Jonathan?
Yeah, I want to ensure that in our institution and maybe across the country that people with disability get services and also are integrated in the society so that we end the stigma and discrimination that is all over, which has been a problem for people with disability, and also to ensure that they are given the equal opportunity in education as required by the law.
Okay, so how you want to develop your mission?
Our mission is actually to work closely with all the stakeholders, like the National Council for Persons with Disability in Kenya, the University Council, the Vice Chancellor, and the University Management to ensure that each and everyone plays his or her role in ensuring that we achieve the disability mainstreaming that we want in our society.
Okay, thanks a lot for sharing your information. Now, I would like to request you to shed lights on the specific topic of today, that is inclusion of equal opportunity, learning experience, and special children in education and public service. Kindly deliver your greatest speech. Thank you.
Thank you so much. On matters equality and disability inclusion in education mm-hmm. and public service. Now, when we come to education, education is a basic right for all the children, whether they have any disability or do not have a disability.
Mm-hmm.
And all the our laws in Kenya, that is Personal with Disabilities Act, ensures that persons with disability are actually given opportunity to learn. We should not focus on their disability, but we should focus on their abilities in all matters on equal opportunities. So in the case of admission of children with special needs, there is a requirement that we should not deny them admission only on account of disability, but we should actually include them in admitting the learners with a disability, and especially to integrate them with other students so that the students can be able to learn, that also people to disabled, they are able differently. And if they get this education, it will assist them in so many things. They can get employment. Now in Kenya, we have 5% that is supposed to be provided for person with disability in an organization. If we have 600 staff, for example, then 5% of the 600 staff should be person with disability. And where there is a requirement of a brain, a requirement of a braille and the requirement of a sign language interpreter, the organization should actually provide that so that they can be able to accommodate them in all areas. So education is key and is very important for every child irrespective of disability. We should include them in education, and also on matters of curriculum development, we should ensure that we take care of special needs children in all areas. Like in our teachers' college, we should have, we should review the curriculum so that we can include special needs education for all teachers, so that when we integrate them in all these other schools, they'll be able to know how to handle children with special needs. That is a key area so that as they continue learning with others, they'll be integrated so that the issue of stigma and discrimination shall come to an end.
Mm-hmm. Great. Yeah. So you have been servicing this kind of great topic and great way to deliver your great service to all your people among Kenya and among other also, like you are also sharing your knowledge, experience, and your kind that motive you have to help our children all over the world. I think your management and your educators, they are helping you in a great way. So what do you like to wish more, that our children are suffering, those who are a special child, now they are suffering to have the equal opportunity beside the normal children. So how we can assist them more, like who to help them, like government or normal people or our curriculum system? What do you like to add on this?
Yeah, maybe on the issue of assistance, actually the governments, all the governments, levels of governments, should actually come to assist in providing the necessary infrastructure for children with disability, learners with disability, in terms of implementing the key policies and laws that are in place so that these children can benefit well in education. Also, we may also welcome other stakeholders, like maybe any other NGOs or any other people of goodwill who can be able to support education of children with disability, maybe through bursary allocation. Most of the parents actually who have these children with disability, most of them, you find them, they are not employed. They don't have any other income. There are even those who cannot even get employment because they cannot leave their children. Their children are under 24-hour care because their children cannot do anything on their own. So you find that it is really difficult even to get even the therapy sessions because of the cost involved, because they don't have any activity that can assist them to earn income. The bursaries, if we can get bursaries, we put more bursary for children with special needs so that they can at least action and resource allocation. They should be given more bursary.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe all the infrastructure maybe in schools so that they can access education without any problem. They should provide favorable environment so that they should also encourage and sensitize more on parents to ensure that they embrace these children, the children with special needs, like any other children without any disability, so that they can give them more support in terms of education.
Right. They are so great. And you have emphasized it. So please request you how would like to wrap up the session, how would like to regard the conveying message to all of our international guests together, because we need to help our children, those who are in need of these educational help, public service inclusion help, how you want to address our international community to help our special children. What is your final message to the world?
Okay, my final message to the world is actually we should really, on matters of disability or children with special needs, we should actually focus on their abilities and not disability. You find that most of the people across the world focuses on disabilities and not their abilities. People with disability are able differently. They can do anything like any other person, like you and I. So if given opportunity, so let all over the world keep people with disability and children with special needs. Let us give them opportunity in each every aspect of life, in education, employment, because they can do everything that they can do. They do not need any sympathy. That what they only need is opportunity. And if given this opportunity, they can show us that they can really do anything. Like even my child with disability, she can participate in drama, ball games. She participated in dancing up to the national level in a previous primary school. So these are clear indications that they can really work very hard and they can do anything. So I'm urging the international community all over the world to consider supporting children with special needs and give them opportunity as much as possible.
Thank you so much for joining us. And I would like to let you know, Mr. Jonathan Metheth, that on this topic, we will also have another guest on 13th October. She will be joining from Vietnam. And this is your great topic, your assistance, your guidance. You are helping your children as well as you are encouraging other teachers, other members of international community to come forward to help our special children, those are in need of our assistance. And this is our moral duty to help them, to provide them equal opportunity, learning experience, and to include them in education and public service.
Thanks
a lot for joining us. We'll meet you in another session.
Thank you. See you soon.